Mother of two, Thembisa from Khayelitsha, Cape Town, South Africa, discovered she was HIV positive in 2001. Through an HIV/AIDS treatment program supported by Médecins Sans Frontières, Doctors Without Borders, she started on antiretroviral drugs in 2003 and became well enough to return to work and care for her children. Now, Thembisa is showing drug resistance and has failed two lines of treatment of ARVs. Unlike in Europe and the US, there is currently no third line of treatment available in South Africa.
I am still worried now because I don't know what's going to happen to me. In fact, there's no such a thing can help me. I know that I'm going to die. Who's going to look after my children? In other countries, there's another lines. If we can, again, we can give us in South Africa, there's the third line and also another lines, at least so that you can be again a strong people.
As a nurse, seeing a patient that you have been treating starting from 2003 and now this patient is failing on both regimens that are available, then as a nurse, you know, you feel that you are a failure as a nurse, and we are feeling that our hands are tied. There's nothing that we can say to Thembisa because they need answers from us.
The MSF HIV treatment program in Khayelitsha is one of the longest running programs of its kind in sub-Saharan Africa.
What's unique, I think, is that we brought what was considered as a sophisticated treatment, only meant to be handled by specialists. We brought it to primary health care, where the majority of sick people lived. We simplified as much as possible so that nurse could handle it. And last but not least, we knocked the price down because prices were a major barrier.
Startling data is emerging from the program that of the 11,000 people currently being treated here, there is growing resistance to first-line drugs. 20% of people are failing first-line treatments within 5 years. Of those on second-line, one quarter have failed second-line drugs after 2 years. With no third-line treatment available in South Africa, the outlook is bleak for those patients promised universal access.
Because we are facing patent issue, and patent means price. Those drugs exist. They exist since long. They are utilized since long in the Western world. But for some reason, people thought, no, we won't need them. What we are saying here, yes, we will need them, and we need them tomorrow. Otherwise, we'll suddenly fall short of option for those patients.
These third-line treatments cost approximately $350 per patient per month. In addition to needing access to third-line treatment, MSF says that monitoring viral loads, measuring HIV levels in the body, and using more effective drugs in first-line treatments could prevent patients needing second- and third-line treatments for longer.
Access to viral load, access to a better first line. Those are things we actually could do now. There are financial implications, definitely. I mean, viral load is not cheap. We're in South Africa, it's feasible. It would be feasible in other countries as well, but provided there is a push for that. The second thing is that tenofovir is a drug that has very little side effects, meaning you're going to keep patients on therapy more than with the current first-line regimen.
Globally, 3 million people now have access to ARVs. But the AIDS emergency is far from over.
We're at roughly 30% coverage, I mean, which means that despite the fact that it's billions of US dollars and massive human resources mobilized to respond to the clinical needs, we are basically just getting started on putting people on first-line treatment, you know, the most basic thing that needs to be done. We are nowhere near achieving universal access. We're far from it. And while in certain places like in Khayelitsha we're getting closer and closer, we're seeing every day newer challenges emerging, and we haven't even begun to tackle those problems at a local level. And we need to keep up the pressure, and we need to make sure that all of the responsible actors, the donors, the national governments, the clinicians, hears this message, because nobody's paying attention to it at the moment. It's business as usual with AIDS, and we can't take that approach now at this stage to this epidemic.